Hey, happy Monday, everybody. Now, this storm is getting bigger and stronger, so I have a new update for you. Matter of fact, I did put a lookout for it as we go through Saturday, growing in a 15% risk. And as you go through Sunday, it gets very large as we get a huge system coming, and maybe even a little bit for Monday that could appear. Now, this is for all modes of severe weather, everyone. This is for large hail, damaging winds, and tornadoes. And I believe we could see some strong tornadoes out of this as well. Plus, what's coming right behind this, just like my last update, is an even stronger storm bringing even bigger impacts. So I will keep you updated. Make sure you click the bell for updates. Now, yesterday, we did get two tornado reports that went along in Mississippi. Some very strong storms pushing through. And we still have it for this morning as it pushes through, and some storms early in the afternoon. So for today, you will continue to see thunderstorms in all of this light green area. But your chances for tornadoes will be over here along the south and the southeast. So here's your cities and states still at risk for the tornado threat for today. Now, we have thunderstorms still going on for this morning for the south and the southeast. But as we go through early afternoon, HRRR is still showing that we could get some discrete cells coming in for southern Alabama going through the Florida panhandle as you go by the early afternoon before it finally congeals together to some possible damaging winds. You get a cluster of storms pushing through, and pretty much the severe weather is going to be gone after you get around 4 and 5 p.m. But also, could bring some more hail as it comes through for the rest of the day for southern Mississippi, southern Alabama, across Florida Panhandle, and central Alabama as well. Now, as our storm system comes across for Wednesday, it is going to bring some severe weather towards northwest. So here's your cities and states at risk for the severe weather for Wednesday. And this is part of our system that's coming in for the rest of the week. As you get that negative tilt, you get some storms over here for the Pacific Northwest, not showing super bad storms, but we do get a mesoscale. We do get some rotating thunderstorms and a chance for some hail, maybe even some damaging winds to come across with that. But you see how it gets together with this energy over here in the Pacific, and that comes right across with the group of storms in the south. And as we go through Friday, it gets really strong for Saturday, then for Sunday. While we get a lot of lightning strikes, a lot of hail, damaging winds, chances for tornadoes, and we still get that snowstorm that comes across for the Midwest. And still showing we're going to be an even stronger weather pattern right after this big storm as we get that high pressure moving in and we get that return flow coming back, feeding precipitation towards these storms. So as that comes in, it's going to be even more severe weather kicking in, even stronger storms right after this one. So as we go through Saturday, here's your 15% risk. I do think this could upgrade just a little bit, but here's your cities and states at risk for the severe weather, all modes possible. And you can see how it has greatly grown into Sunday. So here's your cities and states at risk within a 25-mile area, but you can see the wide area still at risk. Now, this will upgrade a little bit. I will show you more of that on our update this afternoon. Our latest update, you can see over here, Pacific Northwest, you do get some lift, some instability on that storm that comes through for Wednesday. So you need to watch out for chances for hail, maybe a little bit of damage and winds. But as we go from Friday into Saturday, this is where we get storms across the Great Lakes. So for Friday, we're going to get some thunderstorms coming across, bringing chances for hail as well. It will turn into a snow event, but look at all the lift that's coming across for these storms. I will show you. Then as you go from Friday into Saturday, it's really going to grow across the Central Plains, and then especially across the lower Mississippi Valley as it goes through for Saturday into Sunday. Just a very strong weather pattern in general that is coming. Maybe even some for Monday. I will keep you updated. And we still have that next storm system coming right behind that, growing even stronger. Stronger instability, a lot stronger of hail, and even chances for strong tornadoes from what I can see. But a lot more instability as we go through this next weather pattern. Now, once again, this is not going to be the strongest storm of April. We're right into the beginning. But this is already looking like May setup as we go through for the beginning of April, the end of March. Very strong storms coming through. They're going to get stronger and stronger, everybody. You can also see as we get that return flow from the high pressure coming through, that it is bringing a lot of precipitable water right towards our severe weather event as we go through for Saturday and Sunday. And it still lingers around along the East Coast for Monday, so I will keep you updated if they do upgrade that as well. And we have all that precipitable water coming in for our next storm system as well as we go into next week. There's a lot of strong weather coming, everyone. We're going into a very intense weather pattern. Now, it's all coming together very strong for Sunday, but you can see your dew points, all the precipitable water in the atmosphere. And look as you go through Saturday, very strong dew points coming through. All you need is 55 for thunderstorms for severe weather, and you're still getting a 60s pull all the way to the north. Now you're getting 70s along the Gulf. You're getting 60s pulling all the way up towards Ohio Valley as you go through Sunday. This is going to be the setup for a very strong severe weather day, everyone. And as you go through Monday, still have very strong dew points coming around along the East Coast, so I could easily upgrade for another day. Showing as we go through Friday evening, we're going to get a lot of lightning strikes coming all the way from Central Plains across the Great Lakes. And this is right when we get in somewhat of a storm system pushing through, a little bit of a clipper system, bringing some freezing rain. But all this rain up here is going to be thunderstorms with a lot of lightning strikes that's coming through with that, everyone. And then right after that moves through, then we're going to get a bigger event as we go through from Sunday into Sunday evening. Now this is where it's really going to grow as we go through Sunday. So while on the northern side, while you're getting this snow and more freezing rain, on the southern side, right where you have this low pressure, you're getting severe weather all the way from Indiana and south. But look at these lightning strikes that is coming with this system, everybody. We're talking about a lot of lightning coming through for Sunday and for Monday along the coast. It does weaken down a little bit for Monday, but as you go from Saturday into Sunday, this is going to be a big severe weather event, everyone, as we're getting this snowstorm on the northern side of it as well. Then the next one coming right behind that. So here we go for Saturday. As we go through, we're getting a return flow from the high pressure, starting to bring some severe weather in the south, but we're getting a low pressure building in the Central Plains. And look how you're starting to get some cells forming up right on the eastern side of it. So you're starting to get some lift down here as this pulls to the north, as you're getting a storm system coming across the Central Plains to the Midwest and bringing the lightning strikes and that snowstorm. Now remember, all this up here has a lot of lightning strikes and chances for hail with it while you're getting this storm pulling to the north. And that return flow is so important to what is going on with this storm system. As we go through Sunday morning and Sunday evening, this is where it really grows to a lot of chances for severe weather. Right on the south and eastern side of this low pressure is where you're going to get a lot of chances for some tornadoes as well. But this is going to pull up and bring a lot of intense weather in the south. Look at the size of these storms down there. In the least, there's going to bring very large hail with that. And you're going to get the tornado threat that's going to be close towards that low pressure. You still got lift going all the way up towards Indiana. Now, this is still 5 to 7 days away, everyone, on this storm system. So trust me, this is going to dramatically change as we get a little bit closer to it. Euro is not a high resolution model. Showing a lot of heavy rainfall is going to add up for the West Coast. Also, what comes across for that chance for that snowstorm is also going to bring a lot of rain as well, a little bit of freezing rain. But getting heavy rainfall anywhere from 2 to 3 inches in all of this red, all the way from the Central Plains across the Midwest, the Great Lakes, and the interior Northeast out through New England. Also, what comes across for the South and the mid-Mississippi and the lower Mississippi Valley. A lot of heavy rainfall. This is right where we have our outlook for heavy rain, everyone. But you can also see on the latest drop monitor, still showing that it will help some for southern Texas, but as far as western Texas, going through the four corners all the way to Utah, Nevada, Southern California, you're going to remain, unfortunately, in this drought, everybody. Now, it will help for the north central plains, the upper Midwest, and over here for the northeast. It will help with your drought a little bit. But over here for Texas, where you really need it towards the four corners, you're not going to get any at all. Showing you still have a big snowstorm coming across for the Midwest, going through the Great Lakes out through the northeast. And the next storm system is going to add for more snow coming across the western side of the U.S., bringing feet of snow. Now you can see the trend. When you look with the Euro, you look with the Canadian, agreeing this is going to bring some snow towards the upper Midwest across the Great Lakes. When you go by GFS, it's been all over the place. First, 0Z, they didn't show anything, and now the 6Z is bringing the trough way over here towards the interior northeast. I will keep you updated of anything new coming out with this storm system. I will see this afternoon. I think this is going to greatly grow as we go through this week. So make sure you click that subscribe button, click that bell, so you do get the updates. Thank you so much for your time, everybody. I want to keep a short video just to keep you an update of what's going on. Hope you have a very great day out there. And before I go, Psalm 83, 1 through 4. Keep not thou silence, O God. Hold not thy peace. And be not still, O God. For lo, thine enemies make a tumult, and they that hate thee have lifted up the head. They have taken crafty counsel against thy people, and consulted against thy hidden ones. They have said, come and let us cut them off from being a nation, that the name of Israel may be no more in remembrance. for they have consulted together with one consent. They are confederate against thee. Amen. Have a great day, everybody. I'll see you for the update. I appreciate every single one of y'all. And remember, all glory always goes to God, our Father in heaven, Yahweh. And I always hope he keeps you safe every single day of your life and forever. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Have a great day, everybody. I'll keep you updated on this storm system. It's looking very complex. I'm going to have new information for you this afternoon.